Good afternoon and welcome to Cardiff Amps Park for the fifth and final round of this year's revamped Under 26 Nations Championship, with England gunning for Grand Slam glory. England then sitting pretty, and they line up first against Italy. They know what they have to do against a rejuvenated Italian squad this season. Ireland waiting to pounce in the unlikely event that the Red Rose slip up, and then Wales round things off. The table then, as mentioned, England sitting pretty after four wins from four. They've swept all that's come before them, and any win will do this afternoon. Only Ireland can dislodge them at the top, but they require an almighty upset and a series of unlikely scenarios. And that's what's on offer. And the Italian performances have been a big plus for the tournament this year. Only the one win, but they've pushed all the others close. And that certainly gives encouragement for the future at senior level. Azzurri have made big strides. It's a learning curve for their youngsters. It's the bigger picture under the new director of rugby at senior level, Franco Smith. And there'll be some short-term pain for long-term gain. But England have been ruthless so far and have a fine crop of youngsters coming through the system. And many, I'm sure, will be household names in years to come. None more so than Jack Van Portvliet, the Leicester captain. He knows what's at stake this afternoon, as they are overwhelming favourites to take the crown this year. And as we've seen throughout the campaign, both sides will make a stand against racism in rugby and in sport and society, and that unfortunately has become more acute this week after recent events.
Thank you very much. Okay, please join us for the singing of the anthems, please. First up, Italy.
Thank you.
Dickens then keeps faith with the majority that started against Wales. The one change with Tommy Matthews getting his first start at fly half in place of Finn Smith. Apart from that, it's same again with a juggernaut up front. Sam Riley looking to add to his 5 tries in 4 games. He's certainly created a big impression, and they're led once more by Leicester's Jack Van Portvliet. 6 changes for the Italian side that went down bravely to Ireland. In come Baldelli, Boschetti and Kennedese up front. There are tweaks behind as well, with Schiabel, Ferrand and the younger Garbisi, Alessandro Garbisi, all returning. Luca Andreani will captain a side that have made great strides during the campaign. That certainly bodes well for the future. And those hoping to create an impression as the game goes on. Just peering through the glass is the legend that is Richard Hill. Former England stalwart, of course. Dan Lancaster there, junior, of course, son of former England coach Stuart Lancaster. And there he is, a proud father. So it is Italy, England once more, but this in a different guise. And England know that the Grand Slam is on the horizon. Holly Davidson from Scotland is in charge of this one. We're almost under starters' orders at the Cardiff Arms Park for the final round of the Six Nations Championship. And England 80 minutes away from a Grand Slam. First touch for the Italian forwards, and Pantella.
Down by blue. Okay, 9, use it.
Well, airborne, but straight out. That's the first mistake for the Italians by Alessandro Garbisi, and they can ill afford to make such mistakes. Okay, against Topsy Ojo, such an England side that have dominated all that's come before them.
Well, it's an area of the pitch where England have been very strong all tournament. Once they get within striking range, more often than not, they're coming away with points, and it's a good start from them. Tom Roebuck does very well to disrupt that Italian maul off the kickoff. They put pressure on the box here. Garbisi shanks it, goes into touch, and England in a great attacking position this early.
Riley, out it comes. Lancaster, oh, great hit in midfield by the Italians who are up for this game, and backpedaling, go England. It's Lancaster.
Okay. No advantage. Next, Adam.
No advantage. Huge hit in midfield, and that will give the Italian backline some confidence.
Absolutely, yeah. Brilliant defence.
First from blue.
By Italy, probably a play that they've
white.
Seen a couple of times.
Thanks, Ad.
England playing flat to the line.
I don't think so. I think right here.
It's a brilliant read. I think that's Ferrarin. Comes out the back.
Yeah.
Clean hit on Tommy Matthews there. Just the response they would have wanted after giving possession away.
Yeah, the one change at 10 with Matthews coming in for Worcester's Finn Smith.
Unfortunately for England, it was a knock-on in the tackle, so they do get another opportunity to attack from this scrum. And
okay, so the gap is set off your hooker.
And this is where they had such an advantage in their last encounter over Wales. It's a massive 8.
Mark.
Some big boys. You think they weren't 20, but or under 20s, but such a powerful weapon. When you get a scrum that's dominant and going forward, it means you can play any which way you want. You can really manipulate defences.
So young Jack Clement from Gloucester, and that's Harvey Kindle beaten from Saracens on the tight head.
Bind. Set.
Good platform as they go left. An early chance on that far side for Relton, who scored a brace against Wales, right where they want to be, England, 10 metres from the Italian whitewash. And it is an advantage by Holly Davidson. They just caught the Italians napping on the blind side. And it was an early opportunity for Arthur Elton.
Again, all from the scrum pressure. Really powerful scrum going forward meant Van Poortvliet had the option to go left to play nice and flat to the line, which meant the Italian back row couldn't get off the scrum. Really nice hands down that left-hand side to put Relton away, and you know how dangerous they are from 5 metres out. That flat ball just checks Menoncello there on that right wing, which means Relton can get round the outside, and that pressure when you're going backwards, you're more likely to give away penalties.
No question of taking the three, and what are the bets on Riley having a poach here like he's done all through the campaign? It is Riley to the back. The giant Groves takes it. It's been taken down, illegally so. Van Poortvliet, Lancaster. And it is the cross kick in acres of space. But that is the bounce of the rugby ball just evading Tom Roebuck. Well,
number seven.
There was no one out there.
The space is there. I think Matthews, he just doesn't connect as cleanly as he wants. He'd love that to be on the fall so that Roebuck has a walk in, just undercooks it slightly, and then on these artificial surfaces as well, that ball can bounce anywhere. Very close for England.
Seven, collapse.
They are under the cosh early on, though, the Italians. Kennedy say that time, pinged for taking the ball down illegally.
Line-out called, the sack happened. In the line out,
so they can. That's an unconventional way to kick the ball out.
Don't see that very
often. Riley from Harlequins. Of course, Clark, that and round they come again. They've taken it down. Italy are in trouble here.
Onside.
And they'll have to watch. It is an England advantage. Stopped in the tracks. Van Poortvliet, though, he's got options at close quarters. England keeping it tight so far. Here are the runners, Riley being one of them, in the shadow of the Italian sticks now. Matthews, out it goes. As they try and drop it down, it is a try for Lando Bailey. He had the power and the strength. And England had too many numbers in the end far side. They took it inward first of all to bring in the Italian defence. And it's a great start for England in their pursuit of a Grand Slam.
Absolutely. Just rewards for all the pressure that they've had in these opening stages. And they have the penalty advantage, a couple of waves of attack. Then the opportunity to spread it wide. And Orlando Bailey, that little hitch kick there just to create some separation between him and the defence.
Cheers, Sean.
Just there, just that little kick gets him on the outside, and then really good power. He's able to free his hands up and get that all-important first score.
He has got some pace, without question. And it's straight through the middle. Fantastic start for England. It is a seven-point score as it's converted by Tommy Matthews.
Just exactly the start England would have wanted. We'll see this try again. Just Bailey, that ability to get to the outside with the fend as well. Just means that Jesse is clutching at straws. He can't quite get to him. And then, Kosei tucks the ball in. Good leg drive, gets over the line, and brilliant start for England.
Just what they would have wanted to settle the nerves.
Absolutely. You know, the first score is crucial. They've been in such good form, but you know, coming into this game, they know now everything's on the line, so it's just about delivery, not letting
five.
That pressure get to you, affect your performance in any way.
Nine, use it.
Just do what they've done all tournament long.
Leicester's Van Poortvliet, who goes airborne.
Knock on advantage.
Has gone forward, so it is an Italian advantage. The surge by Captain Andreani. Little dab through by Ferrat. It could work as well for Italy. They're behind England here.
By White.
I don't think it's gone forward. Went off an English hand, so it's play on. Good inventiveness from Italian there. They've had a go. We've seen this throughout the campaign.
it's brilliant to see because, you know, for Italy, this is a great occasion for them to really have a go at what we'd maybe say our champions incumbent. But it's all about space. If there's space there, you find it as quick as you can and you attack it. You do it in a variety of ways, and there's no sweeper in behind. That's where the space is. You go find it. So really good to see.
Thanks, Adam.
Matteo Baldelli from Prato. All of these players are involved with clubs in the top league in Italy, bar Benetton and Zebre, of course.
One, stay there. Over.
The outside stretched hand, just getting it back from Fabrizio Boschetti. Good strength by Schiavel. But they failed to stay on. And it's Ewan Richards in there. We've seen him prominent throughout the campaign. A double against Ireland. Scrapping for everything.
Well, it's crucial for Italy if they're going to get a foothold in this game. They need to take care of those rucks. England's back row have been really lethal in that area. And whether it's making the tackle, getting the player onto the deck early and getting over the ball. So Italy just need to be really accurate.
Thanks, Jason.
Yeah, we saw Richard Hill. That was a Richard Hill special, that was.
Ah, textbook. He'd be very happy with that. Say the chop tackle initially for Merrigan, which meant his back row colleague can just get straight over the ball. And say just really, really good back row work in tandem there.
Great balance, Richard, Merrigan and Jack Clement, who trained with the senior side last autumn. Well, Italy, well, they thought they disrupted things legally. Not so, according to Holly Davidson.
Hands passed.
Just a few penalties, needless penalties they've given away, and England decide to take the points.
It's pressure, isn't it? And, you know, Italy know that they've been on the cosh these opening 10 minutes, trying to get themselves back in the game. And Canoni actually got there first, but just there where he puts his hands on the floor. Once you do that, you don't have rights to the ball. If he'd gone straight on the ball and lifted it first, he probably would have got the penalty. So it's just a small technical infringement, but you've got to go on the ball first and then execute the lift and you get the reward.
Temptation was too much for Lorenzo Canoni, which has given England a chance to stretch their lead. Well, like the conversion, straight down the middle by Tommy Matthews. A great start for him. And Alan Dickens will be pleased with what he's seen so far. 10 points to the good in virtually 10 minutes.
A very confident start. And Tommy Matthews as well, coming in into this final game. Now, for his first start, important for him to start well, to get his confidence up, and you know, some brilliant kicking so far. Really clean strike, nice thud on it as well. Very accurate.
Yeah, Tommy Matthews comes in from Hartbury College in Gloucester.
Not held.
Welton wasn't held. Could just gain that extra metre or so, which makes all the difference.
Off feet, leave it.
On Portfleet. It is a tester once more for Italy, which they don't take. It's gone forward. And we saw Van Portfleet kicking against Wales, just on the money every time.
It's just so accurate, whether it's box kicks, whether it's kicking long for position as well. Just puts his team in the right positions. And it's a bit bright over there. Don't know if the sun was in his eyes. You can hear Relton as well. You can probably hear the footsteps. And just as he's about to catch it, takes his eyes off the ball. So Italy's sort of error count rising, compounding that with penalties as well, and just means, I mean, we've barely seen them in this opening 12 minutes.
Well, they'll be trying to get that nudge on here. That is Van Portfleet marshalling the troops.
Crouch! Bind. Set.
And that scrum isn't budging at all. Merrigan. Not quite from England that time. The pass was just behind Lancaster, which stopped him just in his tracks. No momentum gained here, so they'll have to go once more. This will probably be another tester. Not as far that time. And the ball evades everybody.
Not as much distance as Van Poortvliet would have liked. But all started just from that little bit of inaccuracy off the scrum. Exactly as you said, the pass just checked Lancaster, I think it was, which when you don't have that accuracy, it just disrupts the whole move, means you can't really go through with it. They had to reset, go to the box kick. But like I say, so far so good for England. Real nice control, controlling territory. Set pieces looking good as well. Very stable scrum, and Alan Dickens there will be, he'll be happy so far. He's got what he's wanted. Early score, boys feeling good, very confident, relaxed. So we just want more of the same.
He's certainly got a strong squad at his disposal. I'm sure Eddie Jones will be watching as well for a few stars for the future. Italy spread it into midfield. Again, not the first time we've seen that dab through, and it could work here for Italy. No, I think there was an Italian just a bit too eager that time. And they were offside.
Okay, so nine is in front of the kicker.
It was. Yeah. Alessandro Garbisi.
It's unfortunate number because, again, they've obviously spotted something in analysis, done their homework.
Yeah, a little bit more.
Seeing that England, there is a lot of space in between the front line and the back line of their defence. So those little grubber kicks just keep England guessing. And, I mean, they're not far away. That's come off his leg, so it is play on. Just, unfortunately, Garbisi offside.
And England are right back where they want to be in opposition territory.
Good to see, though. I like the invention. They're trying stuff. See, they're looking for space. They're keeping England guessing. And it's something that's worked for them all tournament long. It's just against England, those errors might end up getting punished if they continue to mount.
They're getting compounded at the moment. Here's the juggernaut pack once more. As they keep it tight, Jan Van Poortvliet directing proceedings. Quite happy for the forwards to take it on now. Spreads it out to Roebuck. Jack Van Poortvliet, very quick dart on the fringes. There's another advantage. So Italy under all sorts of pressure now in the shadow of the post. Jack Van Poortvliet, there are men outside on the left. If they could string the passes through, which they can, and it's an easy run-in for Bristol's Jack Bates. Well, it had to come in the end. There was just too much pressure, too much options, and England have made the Italians pay for that.
That's it. It's just constant pressure. Keeps coming and coming, and wave after wave of attack, and Jack Bates crashes over, but it's a consequence of everything from before, from the mall into a couple of tight carries. They get the penalty advantage, and then this is just seeing where the space is. Flood the channel with backs. There's a 3-on-2 on that edge. It's a lovely delay on the pass from Orlando Bailey there. Lovely line by Bates, and it crashes over.
Yes, good communication between Bates and Bailey. As soon as they spread it left, they had numerous options. Matthews. 100% record so far, which continues. And we've only played 17 minutes, and the task for Italy has just become that much harder.
Well, it gets harder and harder, and it is a consequence of, you know, the more errors they make. There is a lot of pressure coming from England, but they continue to make errors on attack with ball in hand. They continue to give away defensive penalties as well. England will just kick and kick for corners, use their set piece to grind you down, and then finish clinically out wide. So Italy just need to compose themselves, have a period of error-free rugby if they can, and that will just build their confidence, build their energy a bit more.
And when you have powerful options at front, it just makes life easier. They can gain that extra meter or so. Has been touched by an Italian hand. Back there is Ferran. important. Sweeping. Just going to have this territorial battle for a few phases. That's not a bad kick by the outside half, actually.
It's a brilliant kick.
He didn't have much to work with there at all.
No, no angle. I thought Van Poortvliet had won that battle. And covering really well. Sends this straight down the channel and you think, right, okay, this is going out near the 40.
Yeah, great effort.
Ferrari and other ideas. Sends it nice and long. Great clearing kick.
Two.
So many targets in the middle for Sam Riley, one being Alex Groves, South African born, but plays his trade in Bristol. But he's a huge prospect, 6'8". And as Topsy has mentioned, only 19 years old. He'll get to 7 foot.
He's still got growing to do as well, jeez.
On Poortvliet. We've seen that tactic work that side. Good work, good fleet-footedness by Menoncello. Our men out there. Now then, they spread it wide. They put width on it, the Italians. On by Drago.
Sorry.
Oh, I think Collie Davison took one there. Fair play, she's back up on her feet.
Advantage offside.
Little dab, but England were offside, so they'll have a second bite of the cherry here. But Holly Davison there, let's see, she was cleaned out.
Yeah, all good.
And Jack Clement, that's it.
Good recovery, fair play.
I think Clement came off worse. He got up, shaking his wrist.
Thanks, Chase.
Oh, she's dusted herself off, Holly Davison.
Really good play there from Italy, though. To say they're moving the ball, the width of the pitch.
Well, they know they have to play differently, play creatively to do something in this game.
Definitely, you know, they can't play Route 1 rugby. They need to test England, really stretch them as well, and it's working for them so far. You know, they have been trying, and they've been inventive, and that passage of play, they got really good quick ball, they put pressure on England's defence, and they forced them to give away a penalty.
It's not changed.
Although they traditionally can play 10-man rugby as well. And Baldelli has it at the base of that rolling ball.
Changing bind, number 7.
I think it is Jack Clement that's been pinged here by the referee. So a chance here to plant this one right in the corner.
Absolutely. Try and give England a bit of their own medicine.
Well, it's been all England in the first quarter, but as we go into the second, the score here would really psychologically give them a lift.
That'd be huge. We didn't see there, just Clement. The pressure off a well-set drive meant that he'd spun around, changed his bind. Clear penalty to give away, and Italy have an opportunity here. They need it. They need to come away with something. They need points for morale, for energy as well. Reward for the hard work they've put in over the last few minutes.
Well, we've seen inventiveness. I don't think we're going to see the ball developing here. Baldelli has it. Number 2, just having a little look to see what's on. Garbisi is there, marshalling the troops. Baldelli goes as they split the forwards. They right there on the try line. It'll be Route 1 once more on the fringes. Not quite that time. They had a second dabble and they've lost control. And I think it just at the death, I think it just went forward.
I think there needs to be a check, though, because the previous phase before that knock-on.
Well, it's going to go upstairs.
The pick before the knock-on. Do you have the ball on the line?
No, it was short.
No, it was short?
Definitely not gone.
Then the knock-on. Okay.
I think it was Jon Nicolai, the tight head, who went for the drive. But I think the tight head was short and then it went forward.
Quite looked ball. Very close. I mean, there was a shout.
This is it.
This one coming
there.
Up here. Oh, he's
was close. Yeah, that obviously goes forward, but it's the previous drive, Topsy.
Yeah, it is. It's the one before. Before this. I mean, it is so close. Brilliant defence there. Just have a look here. How close does he get?
Ooh.
Okay, time off. All good? Time on. Quite scrum.
No, it did go forward. Sean Brickell is the TMO from Wales. And it's as close as
that.
Great defence there. Combination of Sam Riley and Alex Groves on their hands and knees. Almost a mini scrum there to keep Italy out. Really, really courageous defence.
The important thing for them now is no penalties. That will be the messaging coming down from the Italian coaching team. Just keep England pegged back in their 22.
Set.
Just needed was a good surge by the Italian eight. Power coming through. Well, management below us thought that they deserved more. It was a great surge, which resulted in nothing, unfortunately, from an Italian perspective, as Van Poortvliet does the rest. And that's a fantastic kick by Jack Van Poortvliet. He does get distance on his kicks.
He does. He gets distance and he gets the accuracy as well. He's got the ball off the park as well. I mean, from that angle, to get the ball that far up the pitch and get your team out of trouble is brilliant. And from that scrum pressure that we saw with Italy, we thought, right, OK, England going to be under pressure. They've done really well. Merrigan off the base there, getting his team out of trouble. And Van Poortvliet completes the job with a brilliant clearing kick, takes play all the way up to the halfway line.
Italy will just have to try and gain confidence from that. As Gabizzi flies one out.
Advantage not gone.
Has gone forward. It is an Italian advantage. The captain, Andreani. And they have to go back. Nothing coming.
Knocked on by White at the line-out.
From that.
Yeah. I'll stand outside next. Yeah. Just back here, boys. Blue scrum. Knock on by White at the line-out.
Not an obvious knock-on, I don't think.
Sure, if that was knocked on, but there we are. They'll slightly fortuitous. We'll
time off.
We'll have a second chance here. We've seen Italy topsy throughout the course of the campaign. I think it is part of a bigger picture that Franco Smith, the director of rugby, overseeing all of Italian rugby, is trying to push forward.
There is, and you know, when you're making these massive overhauls, you know, there's going to be a bit of time for those changes to gel, for them to manifest, and you know, there's comparisons between this under-20s team and the senior team in terms of the style of rugby that they're playing.
I'm going to stand
definitely trying to be a bit more expansive, less route one. Obviously, that you need to be physical in rugby, but there's so many different ways to get the job done, and you know, we see that with the first team. We think they're evolving their style of play with a view to in a couple of years' time, and definitely with an eye on World Cup 2023.
Time on.
But Italian rugby is in a very healthy place. There's a clear philosophy and culture about how they want to play the game. And the national team and all teams below that will be healthier as a result of it.
Yeah, that's Massimo Brunello. Just the one win, but they could very well have beaten France and Ireland, and it was a tough encounter in round one against Wales as well. So they can be proud of their efforts.
Oh, they've had a brilliant tournament. Very impressive to watch. Two big wins, two close losses, get to test themselves against England today. And these young men will be in a much better place for it.
Well, it's gone to ground. And it's gone England's way. It's a battle up front that there was no movement there whatsoever. And it is the Italian Luce just going to ground. Luca Rizzioli just going down under the pressure exerted by Kindlebeaton.
The initial engage was really solid, was, really good contest. It was almost who was going to blink first. And Rizzioli, unfortunately, he was the one that just lost his bind, slipped underneath.
Yeah, it was bare knuckles for a while there.
But again, you know, he's lost that battle, but really good contest. And so he knows technically what he needs to do for the next scrum. England's scrum has been very powerful throughout the tournament, but Italy, from the last two possessions, will know that they can go at England in the scrums and really make it a good contest.
But in the end, there's an air of familiarity because England back in Italian territory, and they've been so clinical and professional when they've been down near their try line. Riley comes away. Options behind, in comes Roebuck. I think that was just forward.
Pass forward.
Just got their timing off on that one. Obviously a pretty call for Riley to break early and for the backs to put a little combination together in that midfield, but just got their timing off.
Your feet.
See here, Riley breaks, and they're just looking to create a little seam.
Blue ball, forward pass.
On Ferrarin's inside left shoulder, but because the timing's all off, it's all a bit stuttery. Everyone's a bit flat, and that pass ends up being forward.
Crouch.
What's your game? What's your game?
Bind.
Clear my eyes up. Clear my eyes up.
Set.
That time it's square and
Seven.
Secure.
Seven. Thank you.
It's one for Menoncello to chase, but it's taken by Relton. They're so quick to backtrack England's back. And to secure possession once more for Van Portfleet. Well, not that time. Now then, can the Italian side counter? Was half a chance to spread then. Andreani. Gotta be easy to Ferran. That white brick wall is obvious across the field. Nothing's getting through at the moment. And this is why they have to dab it through. Lancaster doing well.
Okay, nine, use it.
It's just the ball speed. We're off the turnover. Italy were playing really nicely, some really good quick ball, but once it slowed down, just gave England's defence a chance to get organised, rearrange, and get back on top.
Out to Lorenzo Pani. Pani finds some space. They're so quick, though, to regroup our England. This is Garbisi once more, but they're behind the game line. And it all comes to nothing. That just sums up the England effort defensively, working so hard to cut Italian space.
Yeah, they're working incredibly hard to get themselves organised so that then they can get off the line and really pressurise Italy's attack. It's also their tackle choice as well in defence. I mean, whether they're making high shots, being a bit more aggressive, or they're going low and just taking the legs away, they're stopping Italy in their tracks, which is giving their defence time to then scan, see where the threats are, and just be really dominant, really aggressive in getting off that line.
Yeah, we mentioned there are a few here, certainly with big futures.
Take
your time. We saw England last week sweeping Canada aside, and it looks as if Eddie Jones has got a few to work with in future.
Yeah, I was there on Saturday, and you know, just great to see a great new crop of talent come through, some really exciting young players, and a lot of them would have been in this position a couple of years ago, you know, playing in under 26 nations, under 20 World Cups. So it just shows that pathway is producing some talent that can go all the way to the senior side and even onto a Lions tour as well.
Yes, indeed. Groves.
Push back.
Keeping in at close quarters this time.
No, thank you. White in front.
Matthews. High Hail Mary is a difficult one for Italy to gather. And here comes Clement. It's just hacked on. But it will be in England scrum five, and Italy in all sorts of trouble here. And so many options for England.
That's it. It's good variation in attack by England as well. The line-out was scrappy. So they go to the kicking game. High, contestable, give their players a chance to win the ball back. And then once that ball is bouncing, sorry, I mean, look at the numbers there. You've got six England players in and around that ball. Swarming all over it. And so it's all Italy can do to just get the ball out of play and now try and defend a 5 metre scrum.
Well, they've got so many options here. They've got the big men up front, firepower behind. Merrigan could keep it in. He could surge himself.
Take your pick, isn't it? I mean, first and foremost, they'll scrum nice and solid. Look if they can get a shunt on there. And then it's about seeing what damage is done to Italy's defence. I mean, they've got all their backs stacked to the left-hand side.
Well, you just saw a glimpse of the threats out wide. Rulebeck has just drifted in off his wing as well.
Same mark.
Yeah, mark.
Yeah.
That he's just hovering behind the England pack.
Just means they can throw quite a lot of traffic into that area of the pitch. And they've got four guys travelling in that area very tight to the scrum. And then a bit more space out wide. I mean, they've brought Italy's last defender probably inside the 15 metres. So.
Well, that's a big, big let-off for Italy. That's an early engagement by England. An elementary mistake. And huge relief for the Italian eight.
Too keen. He was licking his lips already.
It's young exuberance, I think it's called.
Yep.
Over enthusiasm.
That's it.
Number three. For HIA. I think
there's going to be the first HIA of the afternoon. Ion Nicolai going off. And Bisotto coming on. So he'll have the required 10-minute standard procedure now to see if he can come back to the field of play. Riley, it's a shock that he hasn't scored. He scored 5 in 4. Good angle by Matthews, on by Alex Groves. Italians have turned over. Not much for Pani to work with. It's been a good 10 minutes from Italy, a good rearguard action after yielding two early tries.
It's exactly what they needed. You know, maybe a bit shell-shocked early on.
They didn't need that.
No, definitely not. They need to recover here. And they've done very well there, but they just needed this period of the game to even itself out, to take the sting out of England's momentum, and to get some going their own way.
I need a clear release.
Well, that could have gone anywhere that time.
Not what you want to see. Your box kick basically going backwards. But they did really well to recover there.
No, they've stuck in there, shown a bit of character. But they need to do more in this. There's a big 7 minutes in front of them here.
There is, and you know, they've done really well to just compose themselves, to re-establish themselves in this game, and it's testament to the work that they've done right through the tournament. They've been very handy, you know, carried themselves really well, and they're stepping up to England. You know, they're giving it a real good fight. They're in this. They've had a period of even pressure, so now they just need something to show for their efforts. It could just be three, could be sustained pressure higher up the pitch, but I say they're making it a good contest.
Oh, it's been it's overthrown, and England could come away with it. They do, with chance on the far side. It's out to Relton. Garbisi is back there, but look at the distance that they've lost. It's just those elementary mistakes that they have to cut out of their game.
Yeah, it's something that you'll find no matter what level, but continue to make errors on either side of the ball, just you get punished, and the punishments become, I guess, more severe the higher up the chain you go. So, you know, England counter-attack ball, move it to the width very nicely, little kick in behind as well. Italy do all they can to scramble, and Garbisi is able to clear, but England get possession again.
Yeah, and Italy need to be wary. England only need one opportunity. Has gone forward from an Italian hand. Round comes Riley.
Still not on.
And it's Holly Davison plays in advantage.
forward, then off the boots.
Still an advantage. It is scrappy ball as they go to the blind side. From Portfleet, just the big men to rumble on.
Okay, no advantage. Eight has gone off his feet. It's knocked on.
And after all that, they'll have to come back.
Bit scrappy. Yeah. But again, it probably suits Italy because one thing they're doing very well is disrupting, challenging in every line out, just getting up. And it's what you need to do. If you can disrupt that first phase possession, then it throws whatever call, whatever move they have out of sync. And then they need to reset. They need to reestablish themselves, need to get going forward again. And it allows Italy's defense to get set and to keep coming forward. So it's something they need to keep doing.
Just the confirmation as it stands then. England would be crowned Six Nations and Grand Slam winners.
It's great to work with the shoulder.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's great now.
Yeah.
Just a few early tries then. Orlando Bailey slipping one tackle and had the strength and power to go over. Quickly followed by the second. Jack Bates just scything through the gap created behind. And those are the duo that have given England the advantage in the first half.
Time on. White scrum, knock on at the line-out.
Just having a discussion there. I imagine they're going through what their backline play is going to be off this left-hand side scrum.
Keep that space.
I mean, it's
scrum
a lovely position to attack from, and if they get a nice stable scrum or a right shoulder, get Van Portfleet running into that Italian midfield, and they can create all sorts. You know, they can run heavy traffic in there, some deception, and then play behind and play wide. So let's hope that all that discussion that they just had
crunch
amounts to something off this scrum.
Bind. Set.
Yeah, it is an interesting battle in this facet.
Okay, nine.
But good bit of ball that time for Portfleet. The flat pass as well. Stopped in its tracks was Bates from the pass by Lancaster, which forces England really into a nothing kick. Italy will be all too happy with that.
Be very happy with that. It's brilliant defence because Italy are rushing off the scrum and they're actually taking that pass behind the back option away from England. So they're having to play shorter into the traffic, which is really helping Italy's defence. Is Drago there, so the 13, he flies out, he cuts off that pass, that support, that source to the outside channels, which means England have to play a bit shorter. So it's real clever defense, and on the second phase they force England to effectively, like you say, kick the ball away.
Just some 3.5 minutes to see out. Oh, England have stolen it at the front, so it could be danger here. Out it goes to Baxter. Van Portfleet as they go left. There are a few men in white out there. There's a chance here if they can hold their passes. They couldn't. Well, a chance goes begging because there could have been a try far left for Arthur Elton.
Ah, oh, that's a moment. It's a moment gone. I think if that pass sticks, England are definitely in. This is a brilliant steal. Gets up in front of the jumper, wins the turnover ball. Thought England could have gone wide initially. But they go off the second phase, Italy's blitz, let's and go. Just there, that pass sticks. I mean, Italy are scrambling across, but...
Same this one.
There's some metres to be made there, definitely.
So just a few uncustomary mistakes by England in the last 10 minutes or so.
Yeah, well, after that opening 15 minutes where everything was going their way, Italy have just dragged them into a fight, made it scrappy, made it uncomfortable. Say England are making errors that we probably haven't seen that many of through this tournament.
Good scrum for Italy. Ferrat.
12. Yeah, 7.
Bailey, he's dangerous in wide open spaces. Will fend. Out it goes to Roebuck. Good hit to midfield. Big 2 minutes here for Italy to keep England at bay. Van Poortvliet switches it, as does Lancaster. Bit of indecision there for Lancaster.
He
was isolated. Again, Italy have recovered. They're a bit short far side. Roebuck. To keep disciplined in this final minute. Oh, through eight phases now, England. Van Poortvliet spots a gap on the fringes. But it has gone forward.
Still playing advantage. Leave at 11. Advantage over. Stay two.
Still a chance for England. Roebuck is back there. Evades one, spins out of the tackle. Well, there's loads of white shirts left if they can spot. There's a man down for Italy as well. So there's a chance here for England. Lancaster, but finally, Holly Davison brings an end to proceedings. And there was an injury.
Yeah, safety first. There was a lot of space on that left-hand side. England saw it. Italy were in trouble. But there was a player down injured.
Come on, white scrum.
Holly Davison right to blow the whistle there.
Okay.
I think it was a head knock as well. It's Boschetti who's struggling.
Yeah, sorry, front row's done.
Just in that charge by Finn Baxter. A few people suffering. Good. From the customary cramp as well. It is warm out there. But how happy should he be, Topsy, Alan Dickens?
I think he'll be content. That's probably as far as I could go, because they got the two early scores.
Time
and he'll
on.
Be thinking, brilliant.
Ball,
great start, exactly what we wanted. But since that 16th minute, it's been a very scrappy affair. You know, he'll be looking at his England team to finish with a bit of a flourish, be more accurate, to probably have some more points on the board. And Italy have made it a real contest. You know, they've made it a scrap, they've made England fight, they've forced England to make more errors than they probably have done. And so, you know, for a long time, this game has been fairly even though most of the play has been in Italy's half. So, yeah, he'll be happy with the two scores on the board. They're halfway there to their objective, which is the win and the Grand Slam, but he'll know his players can bring a whole lot more.
I think that's it for Boschetti, unfortunately. On in his place is Giacomo Ferrari. He got off worse in that collision with Finn Baxter.
Let's go.
So Italy just need to be on their guard here.
Excellent, thank you. Crouch! Bind!
Final throw of the dice then for England in this first 40. Just squirted out for Van Poortvliet. Good run, but good tackle equally on Arthur Elton. It's there for Poortvliet. The clock goes red. This will be the final act, and that has gone forward, so there'll be no addition to the score. It's a good start for England in this first 40. Orlando Bailey went over early on. Jack Bates scored the second in a profitable first 20 for England, but there has been a rearguard action for Italy. They've consolidated in the second quarter, but England looking calm, they're looking composed, and they're up 17-0 and halfway to a Grand Slam. options at close quarters. England keeping it tight so far. Here are the runners, Riley being one of them, in the shadow of the Italian sticks now. Matthews, out it goes. As they try and dob it down, it is a try for quarters. England keeping it tight so far. Here are the runners, Riley being one of them, in the shadow of the Italian sticks now. Matthews, out it goes. As they try and dob it down, it is a try for quarters. England keeping it tight so far. Here are the runners, Riley being one of them, in the shadow of the Italian sticks now. Matthews, out it goes. As they try and dob it down, it is a try for of the Italian sticks now. Matthews, out it goes. As they try and dob it down, it is a try for Lando Bailey. He had. There's another advantage. So Italy under all sorts of pressure now in the shadow of the post. Jack van Poortvliet, there are men outside on the left. If they can string the passes through, which they can. And it's in the shadow of the post. Jack van Poortvliet, there are men outside on the left. If they can string the passes through, which they can. And it's an easy run in for Bristol's Jack Bates. Well, it's pressure now. In the shadow of the post, Jack van Poortvliet. There are men outside on the left. If they can string the passes through, which they can. And it's an easy run in for Bristol. In the shadow of the post, Jack van Poortvliet. There are men outside on the left. If they can string the passes through, which they can. And it's an easy run in for Bristol's Jack Bates. Well, it had Italy under all sorts of pressure now. In the shadow of the post, Jack van Poortvliet. There are men outside on the left. If they can string the passes through, which they can. And it's an easy run in for Bristol's Jack Bates.
Thank you.
Welcome back to Cardiff Arms Park, where England's under-20 side are 40 minutes away from a Grand Slam. There's one change in the Italian ranks with Tommaso Di Bartolomeo coming on at hooker. So a tale of two quarters in the first half. England winning the first, but Italy showing resolve.
Time on.
In the final 20 minutes, but still trail by 17 points to nil. And a lot of work to be done in the second half. Matthews doesn't find touch. Lorenzo Pani. Pani just looked for Menoncello. Nicolai, who's back on after the HIA. Defensive work for England to be done early on in the second half. Nicolai, good bit of ball, good surge over the gain line, and they'll gain a penalty. Good start, good promising start from the Azzurri.
Welcome return for Nicolai as well. Some really good carries in there, some nice angles. Just punching holes in between the England defenders, which means they can't really make those dominant collisions. Gets his team going forwards. Forces England to give away the penalty. There it is. The fact that he just gets a few metres going forwards means that Richards gets trapped in there and the player going over the top pins him in, gives away the penalty, and Italy opt to try and get their first points of the afternoon on the board.
And points they would have deserved. Good strike from Ferran, no problem at all, clean as a whistle. So Italy are on the scoreboard. It's taken 42 minutes, but points that they deserve. Start for the second half.
Absolutely.
Further change here as
okay. Time on.
Miguel Manson comes on and Canadese goes off in the back row. It's just a mistake they could have done without.
It's a tackle.
Actually, brilliant work there by Tom Roebuck. He's gone around, so off a kickoff, especially if they put a pod in the air, you are allowed to go around and compete on the ball. It might look like you're offside, but you're not. It becomes a tackle. It's not a maul. Because no one's engaged from the other side, and he's done a great job there for his team. Got in, disrupted the ball. As you see here, there's no more because no one's engaged, so he has every right to go around to the other side, be a nuisance, and catch a few Italian players by surprise. They think he shouldn't be there, but he's very legal.
Yeah, just did enough to dislodge the ball.
Crouch!
From the grasp of an Italian
hand.
Bind!
Set. Hold.
Again, pressure coming through the Italian eight. It's out to Lancaster. Oh, good spin pass out. It goes. There's a chance for Relton. Showing a clean pair of heels in the corner. They won't stop the winger. And you can't keep that man out of the action. Arthur Elton scored twice against Wales. He's dabbed down, and that could be the crucial score that edges England ever closer to the Grand Slam.
It's a brilliant score, and you can just see from the setup they've got so much space in that outside channel. There is a slip in the Italian defence, but that's the pressure of the bodies in that midfield. They create that space, get the ball to the edge. Bailey gives it to Relton, and then the speedster does the rest. Great gas, dives in the corner. Rich vein of try-scoring form, and it's a great response, having just conceded three, to go straight back up the other end and score. Really, really big statement there.
Only one winner in that foot race, and it was Arthur Relton. Matthews tries to draw this one round. It's not going to get there, but 22 points to 3. And how often do you see a team coming back into the game only to be dashed then by one opportunity by England?
You see Menoncello there. He almost realises his mistake, tries to correct it, but slips in the process. Leaves that space out wide. The Italian defence very narrow to begin with. England obviously seen that. A bit of deception in the midfield, and then move that ball out wide as quick as you can.
Crucial score, but England have been pinged for failing to stay on their feet. I think it's Sam Riley who's the guilty party. Bit of defensive work for England to do once more.
Again, Italy, opportunity to strike back straight away. Got their winger at the front of the lineup already. Looks like he's going to join that maul as soon as it's formed. Give them an extra number.
Oh, it's an overthrow, but it's still there for Italy through Schiabel. They're keeping it tight at close quarters. Almost under the bar here. Oh, the blue-shirted Italians. Nicolai. He has it. He's going to have a double. He's over and has scored. Jon Nicolai has created an impression since coming back on. And that's what it means to the Italians. And they weren't stopping him from 5 metres out.
And he's a big man, and he's had a big impact this second half already. A lot of carries, getting himself involved. Makes the initial surge. Get some support behind him from Canone, and Italy crash over. Brilliant response by them as well. To go back up the other end, get an opportunity. 7 points in the bag, and they fully deserve it as well for how they've performed in this game so far.
I was going to say, nothing less than they deserve. They're probably very disappointed now, having given that try away to Relton. But they're still not out of it by any stretch.
They're in this. They're playing really well. Just see, have they learned the lesson now? They fluffed the last kickoff. Can they secure it and take some pressure off themselves?
That was so, so costly. But this time they regather.
Use it.
Good counter act from England.
Three, hold, eight.
Oh, there's a bit of space down that far side. No, that was forward though from Merrigan. Yes, he's frustrated. A bit of colourful language, perhaps. We apologise for that.
He knows that's an unforced error, clear forward pass. Can see the idea. He's trying to create a bit of space for Relton there, but gets it wrong. And again, Italy win that sequence of play. They get a nice scrum now on this right-hand side.
Further changes for Italy, and it is going to be Vaccari coming on for Fabio Schiabel in midfield. So a few running repairs
forward pass. Time on
for Italy. They're really getting stuck in, though.
They've been really impressive. I say, probably shouldn't be surprised because it's what they've done throughout the tournament. Carried themselves really well, gone about their business really well, been aggressive, been robust, been resilient as well. You know, those two early scores by England could have really dented their confidence and it could have ran away from them, but they stuck in it. They've dragged England into a real fight here. England have the three tries, of course. You know, they're on their own mission, but for Italy, great experience, great opportunity to test themselves.
Scrum the square and secure, and again they go forward. They're going to get a penalty here without question. They demolish the England eight, and that's what it means for Italy. Well, you would have thought they'd won the game. Just the emotion being shown on the faces of the Italian eight.
Nicolai getting a lot of backs. I mean, it's brilliant. You have to feed off these moments.
Well, he enjoyed that one, that is for sure. He scored a try. That was like scoring a try for him. And they're in a great spot. Fantastic kick for Italy. They're 5 metres out. And this is a great period for the Italians.
Oh, huge momentum. You just saw that scrum power, that secondary shove.
Number one and
just
two.
Just caught England off guard and they were able to just march them backwards. Two. And in response, England making some substitutions.
Well, yes, Alan Dickens sending on the cavalry, so to speak, in Archie Van. And Tarek Hafar coming on as well. That's it. It's gone forward. Frustration for Italy. And in turn, it's gone forward from England. So a chance goes begging. That was a pivotal moment.
Wow, that's an opportunity gone. Italy, huge momentum, feeling really good about themselves. Opportunity to score back-to-back tries and just don't execute the line out at the key moment.
Just a few throws that have gone wayward or have been overthrown. But that Ion Nicolai, he is a force to be reckoned with.
Well, he's a big man. Despite being an under 20, he's grown. He's wide, broad shoulders. He can carry hard and he can scrummage. We know that, making a real impression in this game.
Well, and that says it all in the second half in terms of possession. Albanese coming on in place of Garbisi.
It's with these extended benches. It's just an opportunity to give as many people valuable game time as possible. Obviously, it's been a difficult year. These guys haven't played as much rugby as they would have liked to. So in this last round of Six Nations games, an opportunity to really give some guys some valuable development time, some experience.
So Luke Green is on. So it's all change in the front row for England now. Yeah, 11 substitutes because we are in the situation that we find ourselves.
Time on.
It's been a tough year. Quite strong. And a lot of these wouldn't have played much rugby in the last, 17 months or so.
No, they'd have been. You know, the second team's cancelled, A-League's cancelled, obviously Six Nations window moved.
So they'll be trying to get the squeeze on an all-new England front row here.
Bind.
Yeah, well, they'll have to watch that they're not too eager as well. We saw that
being
given a free kick in the first half.
Happens again, it's a free kick against you.
There we go, clear. You know, if there's an early shove, it'll be a free kick. You know, all these new subs, combinations. Just need to get on board with Holly Davidson, her timing, her cadence. Don't give away a cheap penalty in this area of the field.
Yeah, Italy just to keep the emotion intact a bit here as well.
Bind. Set.
Good hit by Italy. Pressure coming through. Well, Merrigan did very well. He took responsibility at the base. Few issues for England, they've lost it as well. And here come Italy. Albanese flings it wide. Here is the Menoncello. to the other winger, Jesse. Much space to work with. A few jitters in the England camp, certainly since the turn. That's a great carry once more, that they need to get to ground. It's been lost forward in turn. Well, nobody wants to keep possession at the moment. Well, it's scrappy, but it means it's exciting.
It is, keeps it real interesting. You know, England are having to dig in here, having to really fight and scrap. See, this is the turnover from the initial scrum where they're under all sorts of pressure, so Italy are really putting it on them at the minute.
I'm happy, I'm actually seeing both packs, stability.
And this is where it went on from Italy.
White scrum.
Just got a bit high in that final carry, gave England a chance to swarm over the ball, hold him up. The maul was called, so it was going England's way. And
it's probably the first time, dare I say it, there's been probably a lack of composure in the English ranks throughout the course of the campaign. Plenty of time to go, of course. This is where Italy have got an upper hand this time, though. Oh, it's gone in England's way. And there's a bit of afters as well. And it boils over between the two packs.
Leave it, leave it. Step away, step away. 10, 5, away.
Don't think Italy felt that England were packing down square here, but they were all involved in the end. And they'll have to bring everything under control.
I must feel the battle between the
Sean,
two scrums.
Make sure that there's nothing there.
Just building the tension. We'll check if there is any foul play, of course.
The TMO is going to look now, okay? We're just going to slow everything down.
That's one for Sean Rickle to look, have a look at.
Time's off. Yes, time's off. Okay.
I think
yep.
Luke Green is involved, but I think it's just a bit of frustration in the end from Italy.
Yeah, it's just a whole lot of pushing and shoving.
I think Nicola Pantella,
is there
the
anything
second row,
after
is involved.
That we need to look at in terms of foul play? Okay, so the original penalty was for England, and because of the reactions by the three tight head, the penalty is going to be reversed. It's going to be one to Italy.
That's correct. He had no need to do what he did, Holly. Okay.
Okay.
Well, that is
some
bad indiscipline from Luke Green, and that is going to put his team under all sorts of pressure, needlessly so. He didn't have to do that at all.
And it's actually going
they'd
to be
already
up here
won the penalty, and now they're going to be stuck right in the far corner.
And all that momentum, all that positivity that came from winning that scrum penalty goes out the window. England now have to defend a 5-metre line out, and the pressure comes right back on them.
Which one that Alan Dickens will look unkindly on, I'm sure, the England coach. Now then, Italy have got their tails up here. Of course, Pantella, round comes Bartolomeo. Bartolomeo, is he going to go all the way to the try line? He is, he's got the try, they dabbed it down. It's a second for Italy, and they're right back within a converted score. It's a purple patch for the Azzurri, and it's a second for that man, Tommaso Di Bartolomeo.
Just a really well executed line out. Good drills all round. They get set nice and low.
Okay.
England's defence just creaking, splintering.
Oh, sorry, on the 15.
It was just a matter of time before they crashed over. Great take there. Get a little right shoulder on as well, which means they can move infield. You can see England's defence backpedaling. They can't get set in time. Di Bartolomeo crashes over. What a game we have.
It is game on, and that indiscretion so costly. by Luke Green. Now then, Ferran to add the extras and to bring Italy within five. Struck it well, and it's all going Italy's way now. We have a game on our hands at Cardiff Arms Park. And the game has flicked on its head.
He has, and you can see England in response. Vin Smith comes on. Probably their first choice fly half through this tournament, maybe to steady the ship, to bring some momentum back their way. But it's been all Italy, territory, possession. Two tries as well.
There's a bit of nervousness from England, that is for certain. And there's a need for cool, calm heads, probably on both sides.
Absolutely. I mean, Italy need to ride this wave, but not go too far. England just need to compose themselves. I mean, they've been in positions like this before. They're still up, but I think back to the game against France, where they had to come back. The game against Ireland as well, which was close for a long time. And, you know, you get tested in rugby every single time. So it's just about clear heads. Think through your process, what you want to achieve, how do you put things back in your favour.
Groves, good ball for Jacques Van Poortvliet. Smith fires one out in midfield. Oh, good offload to Relton. Relton, fleet-footed, but it's brought down. Quick ball is what's required. It's out by Smith in midfield. England trying to hit back immediately. They have got men. It wasn't a great pass at all to Jack Clement. He's done well.
It's a good recovery there. There was space, but just that inaccuracy has stifled England's momentum. But they come again. Some really good stuff so far.
Italy under pressure here. This is Smith of Worcester once more. Good pass. Back. Lancaster and Bates working in tandem. This is the giant Alex Groves. Good hit on Groves, though. Still there for Poortvliet. Some big hits going on out there.
Nicolai again.
Well, tough and compromising battle. No quarter given between two sides going at full throttle.
Brilliant to watch, and it's great play by both sides. I mean, this England first phase play again. You almost know Italy are defending very narrow, and they're creating overlaps on that far side. They get Relton away. And then once you're in this position, it's a lot easier to attack on the front foot, but Italy do so well to recover. And while it's a net game for England, Italy will say we forced them to kick the ball away, so that's a win for us as well.
He's the danger man, Relton. Give him some space. And he's so elusive. Well, that's the story of the second half, and that says it all. 51% in England's 22. It's just, carbon. It's a reverse of what happened in the first quarter.
It is, and I say with the way Italy have dug in, they've scrapped and have fought it and have worked their way back into this game. No, this scoreline is fully justified. It has been a really even contest, some good battles up front in the scrum. Line-out competition as well, and on the floor in the breakdown. So, you know, I think looking at Alan Dickens there, I think he might weirdly be enjoying that these young men are getting a real test. You know, for most of this tournament, they've had it all their own way. And, you know, as they progress in their careers, go to their premiership teams and beyond, the tests are only going to get harder. So great learning for them, and we'll see what solutions they come up with.
Five, let go.
Pantella was up above everybody else. Orlando Bailey seems an age since he dotted the first try down for England, but here they go once more. They hold their passes to Relton. Van Poortvliet, he needs to show an example out there now. Great hit once more, but they release Smith with a little dabble through.
Nicolai's, he must have had the oranges at half time because he is everywhere. That's another brilliant intervention by him, disrupting England's attack and forcing them to kick the ball away.
Well, he is a man possessed at the moment. It did force a change in tact from Finn Smith.
Again, you can have the best laid plans, but if you get a missile like that coming out of defence and disrupting things, you have to think a bit differently.
Oh, but they've given away a penalty, and a poor one to give away at that. A needless penalty, obstruction. And it was the Italian captain, Andreani.
Blocking the England players getting the ball.
And all that work now means that they'll be under severe pressure once more.
It's the unforced errors, the real killer ones.
They could cut those out, Topsy. They, you know, it would go far to making them much more competitive, but they already are in this game.
It's the one issue that has really got them into trouble, and you know, the second half there haven't been too many of them, but the few that there have been have given England this wonderful position. We haven't seen them more so far in this second half, and
well, Italy doing well to disrupt. Merrigan from Bath,
penalty advantage,
helped on one by Andreani, and the outstretched arm from Holly Davis, and indicates another penalty. Well, they'll have to be careful here. There has been a series of penalties.
One blue.
The last thing they need is to go down to 14 men.
No, and Merrigan, I think, was making that point that they're infringing a few too many times in this area.
It probably is. Well, they're one away, possibly, from a card. No formal warning from Holly Davidson. Pressure beginning to tell on Italy, but they've stolen it. Brilliant jump from Andreani.
Okay, Nide, use it.
Well, they're slugging it out here. It's towing and throwing back and forth. And they've done a work. Well, just done enough. But they know they're in a test match here, England.
They are, and they're really going to need to think their way through it. That was great by Italy, really good to see, because, you know, there's no point letting England get up and get set and try and take them on in that man test on the ground. Make them think differently, get up and compete, disrupt that first phase possession, and then turn it into a bit of a scrap, make them think differently and put the pressure back on them. So really good stuff.
England eyeing a fourth and a bonus point, and that would be enough, incidentally, to wrap up the championship. And there's another advantage, so penalties galore here. It's indiscipline from Italy, and they'll have another chance. I think there will be a talk here from Holly Davidson.
Yeah, it was coming.
Captain? Two more infringements, and now we're not rolling when they're in this area. Discipline needs to improve, or someone will go.
Okay.
Time's off.
She's had a good game, Holly Davis, and stamped her authority on things.
Time's
it's
off,
been an exciting game, free-flowing. But she's not been afraid to influence proceedings.
She's been brilliant. Clear communication. Let the game flow when it's needed to.
19.
But also been hot on any infringements as well.
So we're back where we started.
We are, and Italy will be on red alert, knowing that if they give a penalty away, someone's going in the bin and
just off the line.
Potentially get into penalty try territory as well. So,
well, it's just that key word, discipline, that's holding them back at the moment. But England, 5 metres. I don't see the ball appearing here, but it's an overthrow, and Italy come away with it.
And that competition in the air, just don't make it easy. Get up, make it scrappy, disrupt.
Albanese, England making it difficult for the scrum half. Good counter rack. I think the Italians just giving Holly Davis a polite nudge there, saying that to one of the England players. But it was on the wrong side.
They were desperate for that rolling away from Alex Groves, trying to get a cheap one, but
okay,
she wasn't having any
it.
Of it.
Stay on, White.
Chance for Albanese to survey the options. Anywhere will do. And again, it's another life for Italy.
Yeah, number seven, white sub.
Another change in England colours. On comes Josh Gray. Pinched another one.
Okay, use it.
Josh Gray on in place of Jack Clement
okay,
in the back row.
Use it. Mind the ball.
18 minutes to go. Is there a shock in store? Not like that. That was out on the full from Albanese.
He does all the hard work that his forwards have put in to steal that ball in the line out. Just hooks the kick. You can see it. As soon as he's kicked it, he knows. Just off the inside of his foot, angry with himself.
Plenty of time for England to regain control. Didn't look straight, it's back from Groves. Smith, good angle, good cross ball. Through the centre goes Jack Bates. Smith, just a little nudge through. And it's a deft little touch as well. It just pegs Italy back. It's a good tactic from Finn Smith.
It's clever, they're probing away and just keeping the pressure on Italy. It's taking a lot out of Italy. They've probably spent a lot of time in their 22 now. A lot of rear guard action, having to dig deep. And England just applying pressure, saying, right, we're going to keep coming, we're going to keep coming. And eventually this period of pressure will tell. See that influence of Finn Smith coming on the pitch now.
Yeah, just playing the percentages, are England at the moment. Not pretty rugby, but if it results in a score, it will be mighty effective nonetheless. Round comes Archie Vance. There is advantage as the forward splinter.
Push.
Plenty of dummy runners out. It goes. Relton off his left wing. They're in the cluster, far side. Van Portvliet. Van Portvliet just goes the other way to Josh Gray, who's just come on, still playing advantage. 5 metres out now. Now then, I think Italy are in trouble here.
Yeah, five.
Well, Holly Davidson has warned Italy time and time again. Well, they can't complain, it's been coming. And for 10 minutes, Nicola Pantella will be in the bin.
That's right, it was coming. They were warned.
Entry at the mall.
A lot of ill discipline in this area of the pitch, and as a consequence of England changing tactically, a lot of kicks in behind, putting pressure on their set piece. That sustained pressure is what has led to this yellow card, and again, gives England 10 minutes to really profit from being a man up.
Would you just be able to go back? Okay, time on.
Well, they won't get a better opportunity here.
On,
a man advantage with Pantella seeing yellow. This is the moment for England. 15 minutes or so to go.
Water off, England.
They've not had it their own way at all. But they know the prize is within reach. Archie Vance comes round. And there's another penalty. They've gone to ground. They've taken it down illegally. Spinning away is Archie Vance. He can't dab it down, though. Van Portvliet out to Josh Gray. Well, they're waiting for it. Lancaster was one Well, there's an air of inevitability about this at the moment.
There is another warning coming as
well.
The
last yellow card was for a repeat infringement. We've now got repeat infringements just at the mall. Another one and someone else will go.
Okay.
The sack, the ball has already been transferred, so it's a mole, and then you're collapsing it.
Well, that was a plain warning for Holly Davidson.
Yeah. Okay, so time off.
Wave
number
after
one.
Wave.
Number one. And 15.
There will be changes here in the Italian ranks. Mirko Spangolo and Leonardo Marin coming on.
Time on.
That's Rizzoli going off. Force gone. Oh, they pinched it once more.
And
there have been a few errors in that regard from England in this second half, and Alan Dickens will be disappointed. Well, that's a fantastic result for Italy.
Nine. I don't want
and
to
they're just doing enough at the moment.
I think that's the word.
Yep.
They're doing enough, but they're doing it right as well, because when they needed a moment, they knew they couldn't afford to let England get any more sets, so they get up early, they compete, and then a bridge.
Further change for England. Charlie Atkinson replaces Dan Lancaster. Pat Portley out to Smith. Oh, great hit in midfield once more. Well, that could have gone anywhere. Van Portfleet. Well, that could go anywhere. And it's dangerous. Ball just pops out.
And away White.
But that kick, not an air of desperation by Portfleet, but just shows the pressure that England have been under.
They have. Italy's defence has been really good. Aggressive, clever, making some great reads. When England are trying to play out the back.
Charged down that time by Arthur Clark. Taken quickly. Well, it's all happening out there now, and we could be in for a big 13 minutes. And it is an Italian penalty. And Finn Smith guilty of holding on. And I think it's that man once more.
He's there again.
We didn't need to guess. It's Ion Nicolai over the ball. So disruptive. And wins a penalty.
He's breathing heavy now. On his haunches. I mean, he's put in a shift.
Well, they need him to stay on. That is for certain.
They do. So England choose to counter-attack. They get chopped down and then some great body positions. Two men in there.
Now then, it is interesting here. Cardiff House Park is starting to boil over. Italy have got their tails up.
Having survived all that pressure, the yellow card as well. Hugely positive turnaround for Italy, and England need to really front up here because the pressure is coming on. 5 points, just over 10 minutes to go, and this isn't the position they probably thought they were going to be in.
Fantastic effort here. Now they need ball. It's an overthrow once more. So disappointing and frustrating. They need to keep discipline now. They just need to keep England pegged back.
Okay, nine, use it.
Oh, good hit. And it is an England penalty. And it's Josh Gray, and that's what it means. He was the first man over the ball. And that facet could be so crucial. Oh, he's gone quickly, Van Portfleet, trying to catch Italy napping on the far side. No one at home. And it is the foot race, far side. Back goes Simone Gessi. England trying to complete it here. From one end of the pitch to another, Van Poortvliet. Hafar in midfield, here they go for the try. Are they over the whitewash? Holly Davison right there, but not convinced. But I think this one will go upstairs once more.
Okay, time off. Sean, can you hear me?
Yeah, go ahead, Holly.
After all that, it's time to take a breather.
I just want to make sure there's no knock-on by England in the corner in the lead-up to the try. And then I don't have a clear grounding, so my on-field decision is no try. Check grounding.
Okay, so we'll check for the knock-on first. If that's fine, we'll go on to the grounding.
Here we go, here we go. A few things to check, but has Hafar just sealed the championship?
Drama, tension, and some nervousness all in one. Don't think it's gone forward there.
Nothing clear there from that first angle.
That's actually all backwards. No knock on.
Yes, I agree.
So that's the first part.
Right, we're going to check the ground now, Holly, okay?
Thank you.
Was the grounding conclusive or not? The tackle was by Drago. He came in. Well, to be fair, Holly Davison had the best view of it all. And her decision on the field was no try.
Which then puts things in favour of the defence unless there's a clear reason to overturn the on-field decision.
Holly, we'll go back to the first shot because that is our best angle, OK?
Yeah, thanks, Sean.
It's a pivotal moment in the context of the game. Everyone waiting on bated breath because if England score, the championship is on the line here. So it's a big, big decision. There is a bit of uncertainty. Hafar from London Irish with a superb carry. But has he done enough?
It's difficult to see. I mean, there's no clear grounding from any of the angles so far.
I'm going to slow this right down, Holly, now as he goes over.
Angle, but is there too much uncertainty?
You've got one more angle coming, Holly.
Well, it's all on the question, isn't it, here?
That's it. The fact that she's on-field decision is no try. So there needs to be clear and obvious evidence to overturn it. And
okay, Holly, those are all the angles.
Yeah, I don't think there's anything clear there.
I cannot see a clear grounding.
Yeah, so it's going to be a scrum white ball. Okay. Scrum white.
And all are agreed. So it's no try, but the pressure remains on Italy. And numerous options for England to secure victory here.
Time on.
It's the brilliant position to be in. Centre field scrum, 5 metres out. Just looking at England's setup, looks like they're going to stack four backs to this left-hand side. So anything square, playing flat to the line is going to cause all sorts of havoc for Italy, who were still a man down.
They're left of the mark.
Finn Smith orchestrating proceedings.
Crouch.
That's him. With 23 on his back.
Set.
Van Poortvliet needs stability at the base. Van Poortvliet, is he going to finish it off? Atkinson won't, but the man of the moment will. It is Arthur Elton. Who else that rounds things off for England? That is the championship in the bag with a bonus point try, and it takes England closer to the Grand Slam. That trophy is secured, but of course they want a clean sweep.
Ah, they do. Task one is done, the championship is there, but the Grand Slam is next. Relton again gets his name on the score sheet. You can see there it's an overlap already. has to pick that one up his toes. Fair play to him, but he does it. He's in the corner. And there it is. Six Nations title in the bag.
A brace against Wales. He's got a double once more, Arthur Elton, which just gives England that, well, a bit of breathing space after a tough onslaught by Italy. Relton, and they'll have to make do with a five-pointer, but there's two scores between the sides now, and England can see the Grand Slam on the horizon. That is confirmation of the championship for England. Nobody can catch them in terms of the championship, but the big prize still eludes them for 7.5 minutes or so. That was dangerous. And that would be a penalty.
Time off. Could be more as well. He's got his timing all wrong. He knows it. We all know it. But it's just weather.
He's landed on his side back. Yellow card. Yeah. 23.
Yeah.
And that's disappointing. 23. Just a bit of ill discipline from Italy. But no question, it is a yellow card. Nothing that Holly Davidson could have done. And Vaccari, who's come on in the second half, that is the end of the game for him.
He's gone off. He's gone off.
Gosh. Yeah, you just cannot.
He's landed on a side.
Do that nowadays. You're not going to get away with anything.
No, timing all wrong. See, player safety paramount. I guess fortunate that, you know, Relton has landed on his side, and it's not anything worse. No. But you know, that's shame that that's the way his tournament is going to end. But you know, this is all about technique. It's about looking after players, taking especially the air and. If you're not going to get up and compete for the ball, you need to get that timing spot on.
So it's 15 against 13 at the moment with Pantella in the bin as well. Well, it looks as if they've taken all that Italy have hit against them in a ferocious third quarter, and they've come through that stern test.
They have, and they'll be really pleased about that because they were really tested. Their feathers were ruffled. They had to dig in. Momentum was with them. Then it was snatched away by Italy. But to come through that period, to now have the championship in the bag.
Okay, advantage.
It's now whether can they kick on a bit and finish with a bit of a flourish at least.
But hold on.
Number eight, white.
Sub. That was wayward, so it'll be an Italian scrum. There'll be a further substitution. Holly Stoneham coming on from Saracens in place of Merrigan.
14. 14 white.
Well, you wouldn't bet against Italy. A quick score here and it changes the complexion very quickly.
Oh, it can very, very quickly. As England make a couple more subs, just be tough with Italy still being down two men for at least this next scrum.
Okay, time on.
But why not? They've got 6.5 minutes to make their final impact on this tournament.
It does mean that the outside centre, Filippo Drago, has to pack down on this blind side. So they haven't got the full complement of forwards to attack with here.
Bind.
Go for a scrum penalty.
As Antella trying to come on for this all-important scrum. He was too eager that time. There's still a bit to go on his yellow card. Five and a half minutes to go. That is Pantella.
Crouch.
So Italy will finish with 14 men, whatever Fight. Happens. Well, if they're going to have a say in the game, they have to act now. Well, it wasn't great ball, and Jack Van Poortvliet was on it like a flash. Italy just playing back in their own half. They need some impetus here. Albanese goes airborne. It's not taken by England. And it's been knocked on. They might get a chance here after it is spilled by Arthur Relton.
They'll get a man back on as well. Okay, Relton, no problem. Not convinced that he knocked it on. Was there...
I thought it was a good competition, but if there is, Tiamo
nearly, coming. Very nearly, but Ollie Davidson saying that he has knocked that ball on. And the scrum goes Italy's way.
Yeah.
Arthur Relton, one of those star players I'm sure we'll see in years to come.
Crouch. Bind.
Come on, Greeny.
Set. Oh, 18.
Now then,
and you're pulling him on
big
this
penalty
one.
Given by Holly Davidson. And this one needs to go 5 metres out, or as close as they can. 3.5 minutes. Time ebbing away as far as Italy are concerned. If they're going to take this one to the death, they need to score now.
Advantage.
And it's been spilled forward. That could be it.
Second advantage.
It's just been a few things for Italy to work on. Discipline, some elementary mistakes. Apart from that, this would have been very, very interesting. It was interesting as it is, as it stands. They've given England an almighty scare, but they're coming for the win here as Bailey threads one through. It's a foot race. Italy back there through Ferran. Ferran is dragged over his own try line, and it will be a 5 metre scrum for England as they try to finish in a flourish. And they've now wrapped it up. Right, Topsy, it's time for you to decide who your man of the match is.
Any head on head, okay?
Well, England have been under more pressure than they probably have done all tournament, but there's one man who has added a sparkle of class, and it's that man, Arthur Relton. Some key scores today. The championship winning score as well, and just when England have needed something just to keep them out of harm's way, he's provided.
Cheers, Sean.
Brilliant. Loads of carries. Huge hand in that last passage of play. 14 carries, 131 metres. He's been brilliant today, and he is my player of the match.
One of the star performers, Arthur Relton. And he's enjoyed this campaign.
Bind.
For sure.
Set.
A double that's been so crucial. But England are not done yet. Van Poortvliet.
Advantage.
Kafar came close. It's on to Bates. Bates eludes one tackle.
No advantage. No. Number one is kicking out and driving straight across the tight end.
Go, one last opportunity for England here to really rubber stamp this victory.
Thanks, Sean. I need to see it square, not kick out and a go across.
Going to go back to their tried and trusted line-out. Finn Smith just having a look, but corner it is.
And a score here will probably be unfair on Italy and not give the full picture of what has been a superb second 40. And they've got plenty of encouragement going forward.
Maul.
Ewan Richards is up.
In the five.
Italy trying to show grit, character, determination. It will be another penalty as we come up to the 80. Van Poortvliet.
Penalty advantage.
80 is up. It will be an England Grand Slam, which is fully deserved. But plaudits of the Italian performance is deserved as well.
Absolutely. I think Italy have been great today. Really competitive, really taking their shots at England. And I think the big lesson for them is they probably didn't take enough of those opportunities. A couple of overthrows in the 22 when they could really just put the squeeze on England. And invariably what they found was England would very quickly go up the other end of the pitch. So a lesson to be learnt there. But in terms of heart, grit, determination, their development as well, been really, really impressive.
Bit of a conflab there. But Jack Van Poortvliet says enough's enough. And sticks it out. It is an English Grand Slam, which is fully deserved at Cardiff Arms Park. They've swept all before them during this campaign. And that's what it means for these English youngsters. They survived a scare, that is for certain, at the start of the second half, where we saw resurgent Italy. But England take the Grand Slam after beating Italy by 27 points to 17. Well, it was a stern test, that is for certain. Topsy, Alan Dickens wanted a test. They've come through it with flying colours.
They have. They got there in the end. Because they started on fire, then things got really tricky. They had to dig in. They were challenged. They were tested. But then to come through it in the way that they did at the end, Alan Dickens will be very happy. Now, it's been a long 5 weeks. They've been in camp, been in a bubble, on tour in Cardiff, but haven't been able to really do too much. So they've gone through a lot in this last period, and to seal it with a Grand Slam, with that Six Nations title, it's worth it all. You can see that in the celebrations that we're seeing right now.
And a word as well for Italy, who've come a long way during this tournament. The solitary win against Scotland, but fantastic performances throughout. But it wasn't enough. And it's England's day in the sun here at Cardiff Arms Park. And some of the English squads, including the English captain, Jack Van Poortvliet, is down there. And he's one of the ones enjoying from Leicester. It's been a team effort, certainly from the English squad, who are deserving of their accomplishment. But it's been led by that man, Jack Van Poortvliet, who's down pitch sides.
I can only apologise for dragging you away from the celebrations. A massive congratulations. I'll let you do the honours. Well done. It's been a long 5 weeks with challenges both on and off the pitch. How does it feel to finally be crowned Grand Slam Six Nations champions?
I don't know what to say. It's just unreal. Great effort from the lads to get the win. It's unbelievable, really.
It feels as though every game has had its own challenges. You look back at round one, you had that comeback. Was today all about just keeping your composure in the final quarter?
It was a tough game. I think it was quite our best performance, but we just kept that fight in there. We kept our hard work and came through in the end, and I think that's all we need, really.
I'll let you go back to your teammates. I know that's where you want to be. Thank you very much.
Let's go, Tim!
Congratulations, Dean.
England's seventh title, fourth Grand Slam. How does it feel as a group of players to continue that legacy that's come before you?
Oh, we're unbelievably happy. I think the boys haven't been with them all year, but they've worked so hard as a group
through what's been a tough year for them. So a lot of them haven't had loads of rugby, so I'm just so proud of the boys. The effort they've showed, the courage, the flip, everything they've done has been awesome. I couldn't be prouder of them right now.
Was that your toughest test yet?
I think we started really well, and then the Italians really came back hard, and we struggled to find our rhythm. Our line out started to go against us, and we really started to struggle. And fair play to the Italians, they're a great side, and couldn't be happier for the boys.
It's been a challenging tournament in more wins than one. I hope you enjoy this
evening. Thank you very much. Cheers, thank you.
It was delayed, but it was worth the wait for England, because it's England's Grand Slam in 2021.
not the victory you were after, but you showed so much fight in that performance. How proud are you of your team?
Yeah, we are very proud of us. We did a very good tournament. Sometimes some a little bit unlucky. It's a big match, also today. We have to be proud of us, of our energy, of our game. We take us and we come back in Italy to keep going on board.
And how do you reflect on the tournament as a whole? You pushed France close, you pushed Ireland close. The future of Italian rugby is surely looking promising. Yeah.
We're going up. We have a very good team. I'm sure that next year and more year, we're going to win a lot of games.
Thanks for your time over the last few weeks.
Pressure coming through the Italian eight. It's out to Lancaster. Oh, good spin pass out it goes. There's a chance for Relton, showing a clean pair of heels in the corner. They won't stop the winger, and you can't keep. Oh, again pressure coming through the Italian eight. It's out to Lancaster. Oh, good spin pass out it goes. There's a chance for Relton, showing a clean pair of heels in the corner. They won't stop the winger, and. Again, pressure coming through the Italian eight. It's out to Lancaster. Oh, good spin pass out it goes. There's a chance for Relton, showing a clean pair of heels in the corner. They won't stop the winger, and you can't keep. Again, pressure coming through the Italian eight. It's out to.